across the country and across the South. And in the midst of that, we had our own issue with the removal of the statue of Admiral Semmes from downtown Mobile, although it was not preceded in Mobile by a lot of debate. It just sort of was gone one day and showed up 6 months later at the museum where it is today. So we wanted to sort of provide some groundwork for what if Mobile was to have its own debate about things named after Confederates and that. Where are these places? Where are these streets and these schools or these buildings that have been named for Confederate generals? And what is the history of Mobile? And so we decided to focus on places that are currently, still to this day, have these names of Confederate generals. But we acknowledge that, and this is the fourth panel here, in the aftermath of the Civil War, there were a ton of streets in Mobile, 1864 to 1869, that changed. So, you know, Manassas Street becomes Montgomery Street. Elmira Street, which is named after a town in Georgia, becomes Texas Street. And so this is the first wave of street name changes occurs right after the Civil War. And then we kind of go a long period. We don't get that. Anyone know Martin Luther King Drive Road, which is here in Mobile, used to be called Jefferson Davis Avenue, and was the center of African American life. African Americans always called it the Avenue to avoid saying Jeff Davis. And so when you hear people talk about the Avenue, that was very deliberate in the terminology that they used. That became Martin Luther King Road in 1985. So we have examples of these sorts of changes. So what we tried to do was to find the places that historical. Another example is schools. There was a Robert E. Lee School in Mobile that still exists. It's now in Satsuma. It kept moving north, and eventually Satsuma broke away from the Mobile County Public School Board system to form its own school board. But it's still called Robert E. Lee Elementary, although they try not to say Robert E., they just say Lee Elementary, if you're involved in that school. And so we received a grant from the Alabama Humanities Alliance, and essentially we set about to examine. We were fortunate to have four students who joined us as researchers on this project. And that was Sarah Clark, Madison Richardson, Liam Hodges, and Marley Russell, and they researched the history of these places because we wanted to see who named these places, when were these places named? Has it ever come up before that maybe they should be renamed? And we didn't find any evidence of that. I will say Mobile, compared to a lot of southern cities, has probably less of this marking than places like Richmond, Virginia, or other places. But it's still there. So essentially we ended up focusing on sort of two things. The first was schools. So we had a history of the schools, which is the third panel. There was a Admiral Semmes School. The building still exists. It's abandoned now on Springdale Avenue. There was a